What's going on, everybody? I am so excited to launch Six Swings and Six Strings, where we are bringing the sport of long drive to Music City, beautiful Nashville, Tennessee, and the amazing, talented artists that live here, and raising money for St. Jude. Chris Bandi has been nice enough to be our first guest. Before we get into how this episode works, a little introduction to Chris Bandi. Can't go back, girl, I hate that. You fell in love with the kid trying to figure it out. 'Cause I'm man enough now. Chris has released famous songs such as Man Enough Now and I Would Have Loved Her.
Yep.
Man Enough Now almost has 70 million streams, so let's show Chris some support and get on Spotify and stream that. And you've written songs for Casey Donahue, was it Chevrolet Time Machine?
Yes, sir.
And a song with Nelly, fellow St. Louis residents. Tell us how that went.
That was a crazy experience. Being from St. Louis, Nelly was like our guy.
Yeah.
Country Grammar was the first album I ever had, ever bought.
I was going to Little League, getting pumped up for my baseball game, listening to that.
Knew every word way earlier than I probably should have known every word.
Yeah.
But that was just a dream come true. My manager reached out to me, said, hey, do you want to write with Nelly? And I thought he was joking, but he was being truthful, and we went in, we wrote a song that was on his debut EP in the country market called Follow Me. It was a surreal experience, something I never thought that I'd be able to do.
I bet.
And having my friends and family hear that and know that I was involved in somehow with Nelly in that album made me a lot cooler than I probably am.
The way Six Swings and Six Strings works is we're going to get awesome artists here in Nashville to come in, give them some driver tips to how to hit the ball further, and at the end of the day, we're gonna get two sets of six. And the longest drive of the six, we will raise $1 per yard to donate to St. Jude.
That's awesome.
And in case you didn't know, St. Jude is an amazing cancer research and treatment facility for pediatrics. And no family receives a bill for their kids' treatment at St. Jude, whether it be lodging, treatment, food, travel. St. Jude covers it all. So we're going to raise some money for St. Jude.
Let's do it.
We're going to have some fun while we do it. We're going to learn how to hit the ball a little further. And let's hit some bombs.
Absolutely. I'm excited.
All right. Push my pride out of the way. Make a girl like you want to stay. Took a while for me to come around. But I am man enough now. All right. Before we get to swinging, I've got six hard-hitting questions for you.
All right.
Can you attest I did not send these ahead of time?
You did not.
Okay.
I'm a little nervous now.
All right, you're on the spot. There's a spotlight and everything. When did you get into golf, and why do you love the sport so much?
I first started playing golf in 2020, so I'm fairly new.
Yep.
My first experience was a buddy of mine called me up and said, hey, do you want to go play golf in the Bahamas for 3 days?
Yes, please.
I said, man, you could have told us we were cleaning toilets in the Bahamas for 3 days. It's the middle of January. Of course I'm going to go. Uh-huh. So we went down there. Unbeknownst to me, we get down there, and it is a web.com pro-am.
You got put on the spot.
I got put on the spot.
Well, this is easy for you then.
It was an incredible experience, and I'm not the type of guy that needs to be the best at everything I do, but I just can't be the worst.
Yeah.
And I was the worst that weekend.
No.
So I got home. I caught the bug hard. Fell in love with it.
Wow.
Got home, started taking lessons, went and got some clubs fitted for myself, and ever since that weekend, I've probably played as often as I can, maybe 2-3 times a week, if weather is permitting.
That's awesome. So you're 3 years in?
3 years in.
All right, all golfers know it. When you show up to the first tee box, your buddies are watching, the clubhouse is probably watching, you've got the first tee jitters. You don't know what's gonna come that day. You don't know what you got in the bag. What's the equivalent in the music world to the first tee jitters, and what's that like?
First song jitters. It's always the first one. Once you get the first one out of the way, the rest kind of flow. It's like being on the first tee or being a kid diving off the high dive.
Yep.
It's as soon as you go one time, you want to be out there all day long.
Yep.
shot of whiskey usually sets those nerves aside, but...
I practice the same on the golf course.
Absolutely, absolutely. But kind of feels the same way. You're nervous for that first one, and then once you get it out of the way, you know that even if you mess up, it's not going to kill you.
Yeah.
And you revel in the rest of the show.
You're driving in here today. You're getting hyped. You got a 30-minute drive in. You're getting ready to hit some bombs. Who are you listening to get your juices flowing to drop a 300-yard bomb today?
Oh, man, this is going to sound really bad. I listen to the Nate Land podcast. I'm a podcast guy.
Nate shout out.
That is a Nate shout out. Kind of takes your mind off things.
Yeah.
I love that podcast. I listen every Wednesday when it comes out. I think I don't want to overhype myself and listen to like T.I. or Nelly or anything like that. I just like to settle the nerves a little bit.
I like it. That's probably where I go wrong. I'm listening to Lil Wayne and my juices are flowing and I get 2 points.
Well, that's why you hit the ball so hard.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. We'll work on that, guys.
Yes, maybe I should listen to it too.
But while we're talking about Nate, thank you to Vanderbilt Legends for hosting us here.
Absolutely.
A true network golf course. To be able to have this facility to raise money for St. Jude is just amazing.
Yes,
so thank you.
Awesome.
Okay, now transitioning to golf, what is your dream foursome to play with?
Ooh, Tiger.
Yeah, you got
to
go.
Tiger has to be on there.
Yeah.
And I think I need to spread it out. I want one great golfer.
Okay.
I think I would have to go Jake Owen, incredible golfer, musician. We could talk music. We could shoot the bull. Michael Jordan.
You talk about three epic people.
Right?
That's awesome. Who's winning? Take Tiger out there. Who's winning?
Ooh. I've heard Jordan, yeah. Jake's a stick, but I heard Jordan has a way of getting under people's skin and getting
talk.
In their head. So MJ might take that one.
Yeah, I hear you. Last two questions, we're going to combine them. What has been your coolest or most memorable experience on the golf course and in your music career?
So, I don't want to get hit. I've had two hole-in-ones.
In three years, two hole-in-ones.
Those would probably be the coolest thing that I've ever
Without a doubt.
Done on a golf course. The first one, I remember not wanting to finish the round because it can only go downhill from here.
You've reached peak.
I had. and the bad part was it was on the second hole. So, luckily I did because I just didn't want to have a scorecard that had like... an ace and then a 95. That would have just looked so bad.
Yeah.
That was probably the coolest experience ever.
For sure.
And the second question was?
Your most memorable experience in your music career so far?
The Grand Ole Opry.
Yeah.
We've been able to play the Grand Ole Opry 2 times now. Would Have Loved Her was a song that I had written about my grandfather who passed away about 6 months before I met my girlfriend. And I knew that had he been around and had he gotten to meet her, he would have loved her as much as I do. And the coolest part about that is the first time I got to play it on the Opry stage, my grandpa always promised that he was going to bring my grandma to the Opry, and he never had the opportunity to. So I got to invite my grandma and see me play a song that I had written about her husband on the Grand Ole Opry stage.
You can't. Wow.
Can't beat that.
I'm getting emotional here. That's amazing. What an amazing story.
It was awesome.
That was
an awesome experience.
All right, 6 hard-hitting questions done.
Yes, sir.
Relief?
Very much so.
You're through it? Yeah.
Very much so.
I figured.
We're on the other side.
So now
I just have to watch my golf swing.
What are you more nervous about?
The 6 questions? I didn't bother the golf swing.
These
people on TikTok are ruthless, so if my golf swing's not good,
I'm
eating alive.
The haters are real.
They are.
All right, well, let's get loose. Let's warm up. You've swung some irons already.
Yes,
let's
sir.
Get the driver going, and we'll see what we got.
Let's do it.
All
I'm
right.
in.
Let's do it. She's from a small town just like you. She's got a smile that can light up the room. She's pretty as a hallelujah. But don't let it fool you. Cause she dances, she drinks, and she say what she thinks. She makes me a better man like you did. I miss you and wish you could just meet each other. All right, good first ball. 245 yards. That's
right.
A great floor.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Club path positive means you're inside to out.
Right.
Negative
I'm out
means
to in.
Out to in. If you're out to in, you're basically like a glancing blow on the golf ball.
Yep.
And so you're not going to have as high of an impact and power. So that's something we can work on, is get your club path into out,
okay,
and increase ball speed and distance in the end.
All right.
Your shoulders kind of predicate a lot in terms of how you impact the golf ball.
Okay.
If you notice, your left shoulder is pointing left.
Yep.
So your swing path is going to kind of follow your shoulders that it's guiding it to.
Yep.
I like the slope you have here. It's going to promote hitting up on the golf ball.
Mm-hmm.
Try to close your shoulders at address. It feels weird. It feels super weird. So now you're aimed at the target, maybe slightly left, but less. There we go.
Whew!
That was striped.
No, that one felt good.
Go do that again. 272 yards. Nice shot.
I'll take it.
All right. Okay, so your club speed has been about 105 we've been sitting at?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so part of gaining more speed, which equates to distance, obviously, is tricking your brain that you can move faster than what you thought you could.
Okay.
Your brain prioritizes hitting the ball in the middle of the face.
Right.
Everything else is secondary. You take the ball out of the equation, you take the club head out of the equation, your brain's gonna release that governor a bit because there's no ball to hit. So really let it rip. Let's see if we can get 110, 112, and then see how it translates to driver.
Perfect.
110.
All right.
There's 5 miles an hour, it's underweight, but now your brain says, okay, we can do 110. 113. Let's see if you can pop a 115. 120.
Whew!
See, look at your brain just release the governor, and your body said, all right, we can handle this. See, now you got the bug. I can see it in your face. You all right, let's go 125.
Drop some bombs.
Yes. 121.
Swing out of these shoes.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
All right, so let's swing two dry drivers and see what we can translate it to here. Let's hit a 115. 112. That's 7 miles an hour faster than you were 3 minutes ago at the golf ball because your brain released that governor that you've set. And that's natural. That's everyone, no matter how fast you swing, you're always trying to break that governor of whatever level that is.
Right.
Here's another trick with long drive that even everybody battles. You put the ball in front of you,
right,
and you don't want to do something embarrassing. The last thing I wanted to do at the World Championships was skull a ball across the grid,
right,
that rolled 52 yards. But you have to know that in long drive, we've got two sets of six today.
Okay.
And we only need one really, really good shot. We've
yep.
got 12 tries. The other 11, unlike on the golf course, if you want your miss, you want your misses to be small because you don't want to be off the fairway
Correct.
Too much. In long drive, we don't care how big our misses are. If it's off the grid 1 yard, it's a zero.
Yep.
So don't care where the ball goes, just swing hard and hit it far.
All right.
All right, you're all warmed up?
Yes, sir.
You ready to go?
I am. Let's do it.
Two sets of six, your best ball for St. Jude, 300 yards is $300. Plus anything that anyone wants to match on the link in my bio or under this video, let's go raise some money
let's
for St. Jude.
Let's raise some money.
All right, let's
get
do it.
Get some bombs. Trying to set the bar low so that we can those long drives look so much better.
Oh, that was smashed. 283 yards.
Let's go, baby.
Great drive.
Let's go.
Absolutely smashed. Good drive.
Thank you.
But that feels good.
That did feel great.
All right, you've got 10 more balls total for this set.
Okay.
Let's go flirt with 300.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Take that governor off.
Yep. Ooh, that was fast. That was a very fast swing.
Okay.
Which, if you connect one time with that swing, you'll be 290 north.
Let's go.
Yep. Oh, that was beautiful. 275 yards.
All right.
110 club speed.
Whew.
You were 105 just 20 minutes ago.
Yep.
110 club speed. Great swing.
Improvements.
275 yards, angle of attack almost 2 degrees up.
Okay.
That's awesome.
That's a change.
Great ball. We're seeing instant improvements here, 5 miles an hour.
So should I be rocking like they do on the...
If you want, give it the Berkshire rock. You did it backwards.
Did I?
You did right and left. I almost stopped you because that could have been horrible.
That feels so weird.
It is weird.
Maybe I'll just stay flat-footed.
There you go. Okay, last ball of this set.
Oh. Deep fly to center.
Back. Caught on the warning track. Manny Ramirez. I'm going to age myself with that. Manny.
I loved Manny.
Manny being Manny.
Yes, sir.
Does it feel weird just not even caring where the ball goes?
No, because for the most part, I don't know where the ball is going to go out on the course to begin with.
Fair enough.
But it feels good to not have that hanging over my head.
Yeah.
Just trying to hit it long, trying to see how far we can get it.
Yeah.
Taking that governor off and letting yourself actually swing feels really good.
Yeah, what your body's capable
of. Yep.
I mean, that's amazing. You came in here at 105 and some speed sticks, a little tweak with the shoulders, and we're 112.
Yep.
That's awesome. Feels great.
You played in the mountains?
I haven't and I want to.
We played in Granby, Colorado. My buddy was getting married out there.
Okay.
Played a round out there, and we're like a mile up from Denver.
Oh,
so
wow.
We were in the mountains.
Wow.
I flew a 360-yard par four in the air.
You carried or got there?
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I need to get there.
Still par, which was it's a three aggravating.
The three-putt pars are beautiful.
Right?
Set of six. Let's see where we start here. Ball one. .157 ball speed, 111 club speed, 275 yards. That's a good drive. That's a good drive.
Take it.
Yep. Great ball. .152 ball speed, carried 276, total 297.7.
Woo!
Great shot.
Three hundos, that magic number right there.
Yep, you got it. All right, four more balls this set. Oh, that was crushed.
A little toey.
Was it? Oh, yeah. 260. Yeah, it just wasn't on the sweet spot.
No. Nope.
Everything else was good about it. All the way out there. 310.
Poke one.
Oh, wow. Chris, 112 miles an hour.
Woo!
Carry 282.
Let's go.
299.9 yards. Hey, great.
We'll round up. $300 for St. Jude.
We'll round up. $300.
We'll beat it.
That's amazing. Instead of swinging hard, swing fast.
Fast.
And what that means is loose. What I do and everybody, when they try to swing fast, they go
tense up.
Yeah. And that's actually slower. Swing fast, which means like a whip.
Okay.
All right. Two more shots for this set. Two more shots.
Let's do it. 300. Magic number.
See that in your head. 300 yards. 310. There. I like it.
300.
Oh, man, 297 yards. You're living there. You're living there.
Man.
You've got it. You've got it. That's a great looking swing, man. Those balls are straight, too.
Yep.
You're piping those. 280 carry. Last drive, all the marbles. This is it. 310 or bust.
Whew.
310 or go home. Get yourself juiced up. Fast at the ball. Hit it far. .297 yards again.
I'm on that .297. No, this has been awesome. Right, this has been awesome. I wish I would have gotten that .310. .299, I'll take.
300 is awesome.
300 is pretty.
We're going to call it 300.
I love it. All right. I love it. 300 is pretty good. I'll take that. That's what I was hoping for coming in. I'm glad that
you hit the big number.
Glad that we could get it.
Was that fun?
That was a blast.
Did you have fun?
I had a great time.
Cool. You came in swinging 105 with about a 260 yard drive. You got loose. You took the governor off.
Yes, sir.
Mixed in a speed stick. 300 yards.
$300. Consistently.
And multiple times.
Yes, sir.
297, 299. I love it.
Felt great.
All right. That's awesome. $300 to St. Jude to match the 300 yard drive by
yes,
Chris.
Sir.
If you want to help out, whether it be share on Instagram, share on YouTube, all the favorite social medias, if you want to match, donate $5, $1 per yard, whatever you can do, the more the merrier to help St. Jude and get to our $10,000 goal this year. In 2023, Let's raise $10,000.
Let's do it.
With long drives and the most talented artists in Nashville.
Very happy to be here. Thank you very much for having me. Very happy to be raising money for some for an incredible organization.
Absolutely. Thank you for coming here. You got two buddies. You need to challenge two buddies. Call them out on the spot right now.
All right. Let's do George Burge and Mr. Matt Stell.
All right. You heard it here first. 300 yards is the mark to beat. We're going to put up a leaderboard here. We're going to track leaderboards.
I love it.
College game day style.
Yes, sir.
The weekly pick 'em. You got the leaderboard at the end of the season. 300 yards is the mark to beat. Your first place.
I'm sitting on top of the pole. I love it.
Top of the leaderboard.
Yes, sir.
Thanks again for watching. Make sure to share. The link to donate is at the bottom of this video or in the bio. Let's go have some fun on the course.
Let's do it.
She's got brown eyes just like you. Her mama's glow, they can light up the room. She's pretty as a hallelujah. And that smile, that'll do something to ya. And she'll dance when I sing. And she's my everything. She makes me a better man like you did. I miss you and wish you could just meet each other. 'Cause I know you would've loved her.